Hello, and welcome to the second lesson in this Adobe Photoshop tutorial series brought to you by OneLearn. In this lesson, we are going to be giving you a brief introduction and overview into the Adobe Photoshop application. We are going to tell you briefly what Adobe Photoshop application is capable of. Let's get started. Now, Adobe Photoshop is an application for both the creation and manipulation of images and graphics. What this means is that you can use Adobe Photoshop to create images like artwork. You can use it for the creation of graphics work like your banner, your stickers. You can use it to design documents. You can use to design letterheads, logos, and many more. Adobe Photoshop is basically a raster graphics editor developed by Adobe International. Adobe Incorporated. It can be used to edit and compose raster images in multiple layers and support mask, alpha composting, and different color models. Photoshop also has limited abilities to edit or render text and also vector graphics. Now, a raster graphics is a graphics file or a data structure that is represented generally by rectangular grids or pixels. That's a point of color. Pixel is a point of color. And now this raster graphics can be viewable on paper, monitor, or other display mediums. Now, a vector graphic is an image that is defined in terms of points on a Cartesian plane, which are connected by lines and curves and may be scaled up and down to any resolution without it looking pixelated. So, Adobe Photoshop basically is used completely for creation and manipulation of raster graphics and images, but it is very limited when it comes to working on vector graphics. But the features of Adobe Photoshop can also be extended by downloading or installing plugins into the Photoshop application. Now, we're going to talk more about this later on in the tutorial series. Now, let us talk about installing the Adobe Photoshop application. Now, if you are going to be using this tutorial series, it is advised that you install any version of Adobe Photoshop before you start working on the tutorials. You can use an older version or a recent version. The interface is basically the same, so it won't affect you while watching our tutorial series. Now, the first thing you need to do when you want to download Adobe Photoshop is to go down to the Adobe Incorporated website and download the Adobe Photoshop application or the Adobe Master applications, which contains every single Adobe product. It depends on your choice. So once you are done with that, you can install it into your computer. Now, after you're done installing the Adobe application in your computer, all you have to do is look for the icon on your desktop screen in order to open it up. You can either open it by clicking on the icon, double clicking on the icon on your desktop screen, or you go down to your start menu on your Windows menu, on your Windows screen, move on to all applications, and then search for the Adobe Photoshop icon, and then clicking on it, and it will open up the Adobe Photoshop application. Next, we're going to talk about the interface of the Adobe Photoshop application. In this video, we focused basically on the introduction and overview of the Adobe Photoshop application. We also talked about the installation and opening of the Adobe application from your desktop or Windows start menu. In the next video, we are going to focus solely on the interface of the Adobe application. Enjoy.